We're live.
We're live. Are we seriously live?
I'm going for broke right now.
Are we really live? Because I'm recording. So if you're seeing this on YouTube, we are ostensibly live. Where are we live at right now?
The beginning of.
Nobody cares
audio.
About you.
Yeah, it's great. We are live on Napod TV.
We're live on Napod TV. What did you have to loop audio for? What the heck was that about?
Because Facebook doesn't have a default mute thing when you start the stream.
Oh, well, I don't care if people hear us when you start the thing up.
It ain't no thing.
I got a notification that we're live.
Holy crap, somebody else is on the show?
Shit.
Who the heck
did he come from?
Whoa.
Who did he come from?
Where did he come from? Who did you? No, I don't want to know who you came from. No, don't tell me. We have James Weeks with us on Lozilla, which is. It's the Lulz Polls episode, or what did you title the show anyway?
Polzilla.
You actually titled it Polzilla, even
no,
though
I called it's Lulzilla it's Part the Two, Lulz. Slightly political.
Okay. Hey, Chris Fulmer is here. Hi, Chris Fulmer. Welcome to
Hi,
the
Chris
show.
Fulmer. Sorry for making you watch us again.
No, you don't. No. Nobody. Oh, I can see what we look like. James, I don't know if you could see it. We look like we're on like the ghetto Starship Enterprise. James is Captain Kirk and I'm Sulu and I don't know. Am I Sulu or Chekhov? I don't know.
I don't know anymore.
I'm Sulu and Bodhi is Chekhov. And James is Captain Kirk. That seems somehow fitting. And if you're watching this on YouTube, it doesn't look like that at all, so you may be confused. So you have to go to facebook.com/NapodTV and find
forward slash,
whatever. I don't know why I always say backslash.
Why not both?
Yeah, why not both? What are you at?
Don't work on the internet.
Yeah, it does. Slashes. It works. Just try it once. Let's see. Okay.
I will test this theory right now.
Go ahead. Hold on, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to get the latest information before we get to the. Well, this is
on
the show,
how to
sort of.
To the show
it does work.
It does work. So
it works.
Fight me!
It works.
Fight
At
me!
Least it works.
Yeah. Mind blown. So let me see.
Well,
there.
It automatically corrected it on Firefox anyway.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So it's not my fault.
Well, I don't know. I could try another browser.
Oh no, it doesn't work in Chrome. It doesn't work. It says this page isn't available.
Oh, that's why Firefox is superior. Let's see if Internet Explorer beats Chrome.
Internet Explorer.
Hold on. I had something wrong.
Friendly.
Hold on. This is important.
Internet Explorer beats Chrome. Chrome is literally the worst browser.
Hold on. I typed it wrong. No, it does work. Even on Chrome, it works. So there you go, Bodhi, with your little backslash, forward slash, purism.
No, you're wrong.
You're what's wrong with anarchy, Bodhi, right there. You know?
Well, that's true. I am everything that's wrong with anarchy.
You can have forward slash, you can have backslash. But,
the statists don't like me. The anarchists don't like me. Nobody fucking likes me.
Your mom doesn't even like you.
My mom doesn't
like
me.
When I found that out today, she wrote me
what
like...
What you need to do is you need to let your beard grow out, and then I'll like you.
Oh.
That's cold, man. You know, Bodhi and I... Well, maybe not Bodhi, but I am beard challenged, so...
You are beardily challenged.
Listen, on the inside, I have a full beard.
Did it all slip
I'm
to your
beard.
Back?
Trans beard? I'm trans beardist. I am. If you look at me right now, you should see me.
You have a beard, though.
You should see me and say
you
beard.
You have a beard.
Thank you.
What are you talking about?
Thank you. I appreciate that, James.
Yeah, he's got some fuzzy.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I recognize both of your beards.
There we go.
It could be longer.
We're working.
I just trimmed it because it gets...
Yeah.
When my nose hairs start mixing with my mustache, that's when I can't stand it.
You trim the nose hairs, not the...
I don't have a good nose trimmer. And these are...
You need to invest in a good nose
trimmer. You know what you need? You need actually
See, this is the news you can use, is you need a good nose trimmer.
Right. The nose you can, I recommend, I have.
If you don't buy a good nose trimmer, you're right. Just failing in life.
Right. Says the man. Yes. Says the naked man. Okay. So,
look how well pinky is.
I actually have really good
look
advice.
Look at my nose here.
This
is perfect.
That's nice. That's nice. I have really good advice, and this is especially effective for voters. Matter of fact, I think that you have to be a voter for it to really work. Instead of investing in a nose trimmer, no. Come on, James. I don't judge. Instead of investing in a nose trimmer, all you got to do is just take your lighter, right up on it'll burn all the nose hairs off. You won't have to worry about it. Right there.
Only voters should do that.
It just burns all the nose hairs away. So you don't have to invest in a nose trimmer, but for some reason,
advice for voters,
it only works on voters. It only works for voters. I don't know why. It's like, I don't know. It recognizes how smart they are. I don't get it.
Does it work if I voted once, or do I have to be?
No, you have to be a registered voter who's voted. Okay. I'd say, you know, I don't know the exact science involved, but there is science involved. I think it's like you had to have voted within the last two election cycles.
Does pooping in the voting booth count?
No. No, oddly enough, that'll actually reverse the effect.
What about if you are running for office and you go there to take a picture of the ballot to see your name on it?
No, it's not. It's what James Weeks for sheriff. If you tried it, it wouldn't work for you. It's weird. Yeah. I mean, there have been scientific studies that have been done about this as like exhaustive.
I don't smoke anymore. I don't even have a lighter.
You're going to have to get one. Well, no, you won't because you're not a voter. So it's
it won't work.
Oh,
anyway.
That's right.
It won't work anyway. So, I mean, I wish it did. It used to work for me, but then I was like, why isn't this working anymore? And that's when I found out. So,
hey, what's our first news story?
Are we ready to get to the headlines?
Well, we only got like an hour, so okay, we've already burned a good 7 minutes.
And that's entirely well. Yeah, when you get a naked man on your show, your eyes just gloss over, and you're like, naked man.
I think that might just be a select few of our audience members.
I don't know. I think Bodie. I was referring to you.
This episode's for the ladies and the guys who like fat bearded men.
Yes.
Should I
if you could do something with your eyes and make them turn up a little, James, Steve Miller would be watching this right now. Because he is a sumo sexual. And I think that with a little work, you could totally pass for that. So I mean that in a good way.
This is for you, Steve Miller.
This is for you. Yeah. Whoa.
Wow.
He'll be a fan for life now. So I'm gonna read a couple headlines. Let's see. Update: United passenger violently removed from flight takes legal action. Oh, there's a surprise. What do we think? Should I click on it? Yes or no?
Click on it.
I'm clicking, ticking.
Click it or ticket.
You know it. Okay, so they got a lovely picture here of the dude. I say lovely. He's got a mouth full of blood, which is awesome. And he's Asian, so he's probably going to get extra points for that, right? Don't you get extra Asian points? I mean, if he would have been black, I think it would have been a slam dunk here. So I'm going to read this article, and you guys can go ahead and interrupt and do what you must do. Do what you must do. And if you need more shots of whiskey, James, get them down. Get them down fast because we need the entertainment. Yeah. Social media erupted after video of Vietnamese doctor. Not a real doctor. Well, actually, he.
Oh, everyone was saying he was Chinese.
No. Apparently, he's Vietnamese. What? You know what? He loses points on that. It would have been better if he was Chinese. Don't ask me how.
Why?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I'm asking. I
don't.
I think
putting
that,
you on the spot.
Well, how? I think I think people have a lesser view of the Vietnamese than they do the Chinese, just because the Chinese are like richer and stuff.
Not if you're Jane Fonda.
Well, yeah. Oh, yeah. Jane Fonda loves the Vietnamese people. So the Vietnamese doctor David Dow being violently removed from a United Airlines flight on Sunday made its rounds. He was forcibly removed from the flight to make room for four crew members who needed to be in Louisville. Dude, you think about the irony of that. The Louisville Slugger was made in Louisville.
Now it's made.
Now it's
China.
Made. No, actually, the Louisville Slugger is now made on that flight. Flight, whatever. I mean, really? Am I right? I mean.
Oh, man. Jesus.
Did you see that video, though, where he's like hanging on the curtain, going, just kill me.
Just, oh, just yes. Me.
Apparently,
yes.
I was hearing that he, like, when he was removed from the plane by the. United
by the badged officials, right?
Yeah, the bastards. So he was removed and then he came back on, and I think that the police kill me thing from when he came back on, but I don't know.
Oh, I don't know, but I just know one thing with the whole police kill me thing. I, you know, I just want to say that I would never want to be married to this guy. This guy, could you imagine if he was married to a woman? A woman, you know, women are totally melodramatic, over the top. Could you see that conversation between the two of them? But honey, you don't understand me. You never listen to me. Oh my God, just kill me. I'm gonna die. You know, there's no chill dude walking away in that conversation if this guy is a part of it with a woman, because I'm sexist and that's what you do. You say sexist things about women, right?
That's pretty fucking sexist, dude.
Thank you! Yeah. Thank you! By the way, everything I say, James Weeks paid me to say. He insisted on it, so thank you.
Fake news!
I was worth $5.
You're fake news!
Totally worth it. Send all your complaints to James Weeks.
Yeah, you're actually triggering me a little bit.
All
I'm
right!
Like, what the fuck, right, man?
Fake news.
Holy
I'm
shit.
I'm going to call out the fake news. I'm on the fake
I can't
news
fucking
right now. Does that make me fake news? I don't
yes.
know.
Yes. Well, we're not fake news. We're naked news.
Oh yeah, we're naked. We're fake naked news.
Should I get naked?
Yeah.
You know, if you want to, I don't. Oh gosh, you're gonna. Oh gosh, ladies and gentlemen, drum roll. Oh gosh, oh gosh. You know, oh, this is involuntary. My eyes are telling me this is involuntary right now.
All right.
I am not.
This is how you do a show.
So you're the only one that's not naked.
I am not getting naked. Just so everybody knows, I am wearing a suit and a tie. For the occasion.
At least take a sock off, Paul.
Come on.
Just so you guys know, both my socks are off. Just so you know. Hold on.
There you go, ladies.
Hold on.
There you go.
This is awkward being in a room.
I don't know if that... There we go. There's one foot. Hold on. Yeah! You're welcome!
I thought I saw more than a toe coming out of the pant leg.
No. I don't want my wife to watch this first part of the show for obvious reasons. My wife will probably show me. I think we're done with this story. This is stupid. Do you guys agree that this is a stupid story?
One.
Now we're going to
talk about how stupid this is.
What did you say? I didn't.
This is stupid. All right, moving
this is
on.
Stupid. Next story.
Let's talk about that shit.
So now we're going over to the blue. We're going from red to the blue. So now we're looking at the blue sites. Trump takes more undue credit. Hitler and chemical weapons. That's this is about Sean Spicer.
You hear that?
I'm clicking on.
Oh,
I'm
yeah. Click it. Click it.
I'm clicking it. On that.
Because that guy's a fucking idiot.
That's yeah. It's pretty amazing what
Nazis did use chemical weapons. Well, fair enough. You know what? If you consider Nazi Germany and their people being the Aryan German race or whatever. They technically didn't use chemical weapons on their own people.
It sounds like you're.
Sounds like you're a bit of an apologist there.
Yeah, sounds like you're a
little bit of an apologist there.
Sounds like a little bit of Holocaust denial.
I'm trying to find the tiniest sliver this guy could justify for fucking up history this bad.
So I went.
There's no justification.
I went to.
He's we gassed our own people.
I went to factcheck.org.
Chemical weapons experiments. We nuked Japan twice.
I went to factcheck.org and they felt the need to write a book to rebut him. I mean, do you really need to write a book to rebut him? I mean, my rebuttal to him is Sean Spicer, rebuttal, idiot. There you go. See, ladies and gentlemen, there you go. There's the fact check, idiot.
Seriously. What does he think Zyklon B was?
Is that
not a chemical? Last I checked, that's a chemical.
Nazis developed sarin.
This is my impression of Sean Spicer in the follow-up where they ask him to clarify.
I gotta for the White House, and I don't know.
Hold on, I gotta go. I gotta go. I'll give it to
I'll give. I'm gonna do a special favor for Trump right now, and I'm gonna tell him what he needs to do.
All right, he needs to fire Spicer.
He needs to fire Spicer.
Yes.
He needs to fire Spicer.
Yeah,
he would be better off by putting a Amazon Echo. That's the podium.
Right. Absolutely.
That would be a better press secretary.
I think.
And answer questions more accurately than Spicer. So there you go, Trump. It'll probably save you some money. I'm pretty sure that $179 is cheaper than whatever you're paying Spicer. And I'm pretty sure the Amazon Echo will be able to answer things.
Actually, there's where you're wrong. Spicer's being paid in fava beans. So
no. Well, that might explain
so you're wrong about that.
A shitty press secretary.
Yes, exactly. Little known factoid there. So
the lady that cut his fava bean rations in half.
Yes. Yes. And then maybe, yes. And then, yes, exactly. So
he's down to a fava bean a day.
The less talking he does, the better. Let's just, you know, when your house is on fire, you don't call a pyromaniac to control the fire. Sean Spicer as damage control.
Actually, sometimes you do.
No, don't ruin.
A lot of firefighters.
Oh my gosh! You guys seriously suck. Seriously, I hate you. I hate you. You just Facebooked me just now. Not even on Facebook, and you face. Well, I guess we are on Facebook.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Pretend to be you in the comments.
Yes. Hey. I put pretend to be me. Or I pretend to be you in the comments, and Bodhi answered. Like he was, I got you, man. I totally got you. So we're gonna go back to the Reds here. So we've got.
Forget the left-right paradigm.
Well, okay. Well, then you give me something that's not a left-right paradigm.
Just go to the articles and talk to them nonpartisanly.
Yeah, don't even tell us what it is.
Don't tell us what it is.
Okay, I won't
be surprised.
Oh, come on. I mean,
yeah, let us guess.
Most of the time, you can tell.
We'll vote.
No, we're going to guess.
Okay. T-Rex meets with Russian President Vladimir Putin for 2 hours in Moscow.
Totally red.
Yep.
Bodhi?
It's got to be red.
It's totally red. Are we clicking on it?
Clicking on red.
We're clicking on red. We're clicking on T-Rex. I think Lozilla would be a little bit triggered by this whole T-Rex thing because I don't think that... You know, Lozilla probably as a lizard is saying, not in my name.
I think I'm going to get a Lozilla tattoo.
Me too. I already have
one. Right on my butt cheek.
I already have one. I'm not going to tell you where it's at, though.
It's on your butt cheek.
Right. So.
It's on his appendage.
T-Rex meets with Russian president. I guess we shouldn't even tell him where the site is, right? We don't want to give sites plugs, do we?
Nah, fuck the sites.
You know what? It's all fake news. It's all fake news.
Maybe in the comments we'll put it.
Nah. I mean, we'd have to go back and do work. I don't want to do work. I'm not about work. Work is not a thing. T-Rex meets with Russian President Vladimir Putin for 2 hours in Moscow. We said yesterday that Putin flinched. We were wrong. It was much more than a flinch. Dun, dun, dun! I like that dramatic.
Did they write that?
Yeah, they literally wrote that. Well, they didn't write dun-dun-dun. They should have written dun-dun-dun, though. Russian President Vladimir Putin relies upon the appearance of strength for his domestic political influence. What most of the media are missing from today's visit by Secretary of State...
On whose authority? Did they ask the guy?
Exactly, yes. I don't think that... James, on your authority? Would you have something to do with this?
How do you just know why they're thinking certain
ways? I think that this person is not acting under my authority.
I think this person is not acting under my authority. I think the person who wrote this article is assuming authority that this person does not have. Including,
I think they just assumed his authority.
I think they just assumed his authority, which is like a hate crime now.
That is a hate crime.
That absolutely is. So let's see. I got to reveal this person who wrote this.
I mean, realistically.
Reveal who committed the hate crime.
Once I reveal the name of the person who wrote this, it'll be like really easy to find them. The person's name is Sundance. I kid you not. The person's name is Sundance. This is reliable news, folks. This is totally accountable, reliable news.
Sundance is the author's name.
Sundance. One word by Sundance, posted on April 12th.
That's actually pretty badass.
Oh, is it?
A one word name.
Really? Like Madonna?
Like if Bodhi just went by Bodhi.
He does go by Bodhi.
If I was just known as Bodhi.
He had no other names but Bodhi.
Just Bodhi.
If you were just Bodhi, not Andrew Marich. Not Bodhi Agora. What was the other one? Gay Snake. Right.
That's two words though.
I know, that's what I'm saying, but those are words that he
could combine them into one word.
Yes, Gusneck.
That would be a name.
That might draw a different crowd.
You know what? Who are you to judge crowds? As long as they pay.
As long as they pay you.
Like this crowd is paying. They're not paying us.
Nobody's
paying us to do this. Well, that's what we're telling James, and we're just gonna go with that. Russian President Vladimir. Okay, I already read that. Let's see. Okay. Oh, here's the quote from Rex Tillerson. Are you guys ready for the quote? Rex Tillerson. He's T-Rex, man.
Rex Tillerson.
I'm gonna read the whole. He's the Secretary of State. Pretend that you're.
Who's that?
He's the Secretary of your state. Okay. Whatever state your state is. Yeah, but you do. You whatever.
I'm a stateless embodiment of the void.
Even your statelessness is a state. So he's the Secretary of your state. Even if your state is stateless.
James taught me that's a spook.
Spooks are good. He's the Secretary of Spooks.
He seemed pretty spooky there, Paul.
He's the Secretary of Spooks. So I'm going to read the quote, and if you guys don't interrupt me, I'm going to read the whole thing.
Closer a spook.
Our meeting today, Closer
a spook.
Oh, wait. No, hold on. I have...
Look how spook Paul is about his
hold on.
Look at him.
He's spooky. At least he loses the jacket.
This is actually my skin, okay? Don't judge. I have an infection.
You're judging me because I have an infection.
I don't even have appropriate chest hair. I have the appropriate
voice for Rex Tillerson. Ready?
Okay.
Our meeting today comes at an important moment in the relationship so that we can further clarify areas of common objectives, areas of common interest, even when our tactical approaches may be different. And I look forward to a very open, candid, frank exchange so that we can better define the U.S.-Russia relationship from this point forward. See, that's when you hear Rex Tillerson. That's the voice that you need to hear in your head.
I agree with that.
I think that pretty much says it all. I think we're done with this story.
Christine asked us, why are we shirtless?
I don't know why they're shirtless. That's a better question. Why? Why not? Why ask why?
Why isn't Paul shirtless?
Why ask why?
That's the real question.
He's wearing a jacket. It's probably extra warm. He's sweating. I'm putting him on the spot.
I'm not a conformist.
Did you know Paul Gordon has a third nipple?
Breaking news.
I told you live on Lulzilla Part 2, slightly political. Paul Gordon's third nipple.
I told you that in confidence.
Is huge.
I told you that in confidence.
Is like the entirety of his chest.
He's pretty much all
third nipple.
it's one nipple.
A giant nipple.
Giant.
And then he has two little nipples on either side.
Caleb says, I won't take anything you say seriously until Paul takes his shirt off.
I don't care. I am not going to be. I will not comply.
us.
You're
in,
not
in a room with no shirts on.
You're not the boss of me, okay? No, you're not the boss of me.
No, you're.
You're not my dad. I'm gonna read the next headline here. I'm gonna try and find something that I think.
Let's get moving on.
I'm okay.
Let's see what's next.
Okay. Now I have to try to find a headline that doesn't like immediately
stick out.
Yeah, because most of them do. I mean, like this one. I'm not counting this one. Pure evil versus Democratic gubernatorial's hopeful campaign strategy is a new low. Gee, I wonder who wrote that.
I think that was Republicans.
That would be correct.
Probably.
That would be correct. I don't know. I don't know, man. UN peacekeepers who created child sex ring in Haiti were never punished.
Never punished.
Never punished.
We went to Pizzagate.
What are we thinking?
They're fucking
time's ticking,
people.
Dude. We can't have silence on this show. It's illegal.
They're terrible people. It's just that what something
UN
like that.
UN law.
Wow.
Okay, come on. I'll give you a thug. Do. No, if I do that, we'll get copyrighted. We won't be able to monetize this site and make the serious bank that we've been. Never mind.
Yeah.
Wait.
You don't
minute
need.
Now.
You don't need to know about that.
Wait. A
just kick,
now.
Drink. Just you know what.
Wait.
Faba
I got
beans.
This taxation of theft gun, and don't make me use it.
Oh wait. Oh, let me see your taxation of theft gun. Where? Oh, that's nice. Where'd you get that? That is sweet.
Probably
don't
got
worry
it
about it.
Probably got it on the internet.
Okay, I'm gonna see. I have one. I have a taxation.
Hand over the money.
Hold on.
Hand over the money, Paul.
I have a taxation of theft gun. See?
Oh,
right
we're,
there.
We're doing that.
See? I have a taxation. I have a taxation of theft gun right here. Hey, this is an airsoft gun, but it looks really realistic. You like that airsoft gun? It's pretty realistic, isn't it?
It's a 9mm airsoft gun.
9mm airsoft gun is what that is.
Yeah, you gotta wear paintball gear for that one.
Yeah, God, I need a bigger boat. I don't know why that was relevant. But.
I was trying to get caught by the feds, not realizing that, unfortunately, I lost all my guns in a tragic boating accident.
Well, so did I. All I have is these airsoft guns.
Yeah, see, that's and it. It's really a tragic story because I was out on the boat and...
Were you on Lake Superior?
Yeah, it was Lake Superior.
So was I.
And so I'm on Lake Superior, and I have all my guns and all my ammunition and all my.
That's
Bitcoin,
what you do. That's what
and
you do.
All my gold, silver, all my valuables, everything valuable I had out on this boat. I don't know what I was doing with all this on the boat.
This is SOP for boating trips. SOP
all
right
of a sudden,
here.
A shark came out of nowhere.
Superior shark, right?
Shark and it jumped up and you know I what are you gonna do and then it's on fire
no and then lightning hit and then a plague of frogs hit it
just, and I lost like all my guns and all my Bitcoin and all my gold and all my silver. I lost all that stuff.
It's all
I don't have any of that anymore.
It's all a pile of dust at the bottom of Lake Superior.
Those damn wow. on fire sharks, they'll get you every time.
No, absolutely. So what are we thinking of the UN peacekeepers? What do we got here?
UN peacekeepers.
I'm not going to click on that one because that's way too serious, man.
I hate the UN.
I don't like for serious.
The UN needs to go fuck itself.
Right. Let me. Hold on. Trump threatens to stop insurance payments for poor as Obamacare repeal leverage. Gee, I wonder who wrote that. That was obvious. I'm telling you, these titles are definitely
the left.
That's a bluey. That is a bluey.
Same with the diarrhea article.
Right.
Do we win prizes for guessing?
Yes, you do. You win a fava bean. It's in
every
the
time we guess right, Paul takes off an article of clothing.
No, well, I don't agree to that. You know what? You're trying to go to the social contract.
Democracy.
Democracy. Cheering makes it right.
Demob is spoken.
Makes it right.
I mean, my representatives.
We're going to get you naked one of these days.
Devote.
I'll take clothes off. No fascist USA.
DeVos revokes Obama policy. protecting student loan borrowers from abusive customer service. That's boring, man. That's a boring title. I'm telling you, all these titles are like, I have to say.
Political news sucks.
It does, man. We got to do something. Maybe we're going to have to make stuff up to make it exciting because Trump advisor to MSNBC's.
Chris Fulmer has commented.
Chris, hey, Chris, how you doing, buddy?
Says he feels like he needs to be drunk or high to fully enjoy the show.
That
and
is
naked.
That is a bald face.
And naked, yeah.
That is a bald face lie from a man with a whore mouth. And you know it, Chris. So, he knows.
Our viewers whore mouths. Hey, yeah.
They love
it. If you want, go to Nepot TV's page and post a shirtless, topless picture of yourself to join the show.
Please don't do that.
Yeah, just post topless.
I do not endorse this.
Inbox me.
This is not an endorsement.
Inbox me.
Inbox me. We can send it to him too, so he won't be able to avoid it.
No matter what happens, Paul.
Hold on. Okay. Oh my god. I am like, there's a whole bunch of things that were just playing in my head. I'm not sure what was real or what was not real.
I think his pants came off.
No, I clicked on one of these.
You're getting inbox, aren't you?
You're getting inbox.
I am not.
I am confused. There's a whole bunch of things that were just playing in my head. It's still doing it. What was real? Hold on.
I'm getting an echo of the show, and then I was getting an echo of the show, and then I was getting an echo of the show. Now, what's interesting, on the YouTube version of the show, you're going to hear that part, folks. You're going to hear the echo part of the show. So. So I don't know what to do, but I had to click out of my browser. So somebody have a story. Come on, quick. Give me a story.
Well, we can talk about Old Crow, the original.
Old Crow, the original? Is that a political news story?
The original sour mash whiskey.
Okay.
I think that's important news.
Now you know. It's also a commie drink, and James is drinking it.
I'm drinking a commie drink.
I don't judge. I'm not judging. I'm just keeping 10 feet away at all times. But I'm not judging.
I'm only coming for your toothbrushes.
Crouching Tiger, Hidden Kami.
Dude, I will. I have a really nice.
Oh my God. That's why he was removed from the plane. He was a Kami.
Wow. Dude, they didn't understand the helicopter meme. They thought it was a plane meme. United was trying to take commies for plane rides. That's not the right one, dude. It's helicopters.
Commies for overbooked flights on United.
Yeah, I think
this is what. But back to that.
Oh, we're going back to that now. Go ahead.
I was reading it. I'm going to figure this out because I was reading that the plane wasn't actually overbooked.
Yeah, I think they're just racist.
That they were making room for four of their employees who needed to get somewhere.
It's their property, man. It's their property.
I think
man.
That's what it was. It wasn't really an overbooked flight.
But what was up with the hit stories on that guy too? They're talking about him.
Yeah, there was someone that tried saying he was banging prostitutes or something.
How
does that not make him a badass?
Yeah, it was like he murdered puppy baby human.
And he's like 65 or something. Like, wow, that guy's
he like turned in his he's not. That's why when I was reading it, I said it's a doctor, not a real doctor. Because allegedly, he got his license revoked. I don't really care about the United States.
Got it back?
I'm not gonna lie to you. The United story is like
there was all a bunch of bullshit.
The only thing that matters to me in the United story is the memes, and the memes are golden. So on that front, hey, spot on.
I have breaking news. Breaking news.
Breaking news. Well, it's news and it's breaking, so it's breaking news. I get it.
Yeah, there we go.
I get it.
So, apparently United is going to refund every passenger's airfare for that flight.
Oh, that's going to... Oh, you know what they just did?
What does that do?
You know what they just did? You know what they just did? They're like... lawsuit settling out of court. We just admitted culpability. But I don't understand. They did. Didn't their stock
value?
Their CEO
did too by going up and apologizing for it.
Oh yeah, he's
their CEO. Totally,
your CEO, like, man.
Guy's lawyer, is going.
Oh yeah. Oh, they're probably already saying, you know, we're settling, right? Oh yeah, yeah, we're settling. Yeah. This guy's, I don't know what he's going to do with his, I'm going to guess. Ooh, we should have a pool. I don't know who would be patient enough to follow.
He's going to buy
8.3 million.
Airline.
8.3 million.
What?
I'm guessing 8.3 million.
I'm guessing he's going to get, I'm going to go 8.31.
And Bodie, oh, you're gonna prices right me. Oh, you're gonna prices right me. That is cold. That is cold.
I'm just gonna say a dollar.
Oh, that's wrong. That is wrong. You people suck.
You just got prices right.
I know. First, I got Facebooked earlier. Now I get priced right. You tried to socially shame me into being naked. That didn't work. You know
Where's
what?
Bob Barker now.
I stand defiant. I stand defiant. I'm. You know what? I'm gonna switch gears on us. I'm gonna actually go to.
Yeah, because you lost.
No. I'm gonna go to switch gears because this political stuff really sucks, doesn't it? It really does, man. It's like I feel icky. I feel like dirty. I don't know about you guys.
I'm cool. I feel clean. I feel naked.
Yeah. Or maybe it's because I'm wearing clothes.
That's the problem, it's because you're wearing clothes. If you weren't wearing clothes, you're dirty.
Hey, how about this one? California residents use paint phallic symbols to draw attention to unfixed potholes.
This is old news.
Yeah, it's old.
It says odd news. It's April 12th, 2017. What the
that
heck?
That has been good. Couple years ago, they were
recycled.
People
have been drawing dicks on holes for the longest time.
Wow, Bodie, do you hear the words that come out of your mouth? Do you even care?
It's a fact.
Do you even care?
Did you see the dicks that come around the holes?
Do you even care?
Are you aware with what happens with dicks and holes?
I planned on pitching this show to Disney, and now. That's out the window.
Disney's gonna eat this shit up, man. You didn't see
there.
This is a new story. This is a new story. So I know
it's
happened before.
It's
not. It's from Fox 40, April 11th, 2017. Dude, it's new.
What if it's new people doing it?
That's what I'm saying. It's new people.
They're copycats. They should fuck off.
Yeah.
My
IPs, man.
Hold on, I'm playing the video.
Let's hear the goddamn story. Please.
Oh, no, okay, never mind. Advertisement, your video will resume shortly. I don't want to hear
your
freaking
who's these jackasses that put advertisements on videos?
People trying to make money off of producing content
this
is why I'm a commie.
Yeah.
That's right. That's exciting. I get it.
I download the videos and I rip them. And if there's ads in between, I edit them out.
Well, we're doing this on the fly. I'm not doing a pre-production fancy schmancy Bodie's top 10 show.
You know, people are going to edit that and like be like, James just admitted he's a commie.
Oh, you know what? You know what, James? You know what? I'm going to edit it, and
That's your ringtone, isn't it?
No, I would never do that to my wife. I don't want her hearing that voice. Nope, not doing it. I am going to create a 10-hour video. James Weeks admits he's a commie, and he believes it so much, he repeats it for 10 hours. Yes. Listen, don't believe me? Listen to the whole
coming.
And put it to some sweet beats, though.
Right, and before you... and
put it to some sweet beats, I'm going to Nazi punch you, man.
And before you prejudge, you need to listen to the whole video first. Because if you haven't listened to the 10-hour video, don't come and talk to me about this. You need to listen to the whole 10-hour video. I'm waiting for this video to come up. I got the... come on, man. You know what? You suck. 105, 106... Come on. Somewhat in Placerville is using spray paint and some phallic symbols. Phallic symbols, boys and girls, that's just like giraffes. Just think of it as giraffes. They're just drawing giraffes. That's what that is.
Long neck to short neck giraffes.
Right. Long neck giraffes. Well,
wide neck.
I guess if we're.
It's like that thing I was teaching you before. I can't hit the bottom of a tuna can, but I can scrape the sides.
Some results may vary. Neighbors in the area say the potholes along the street have gone unrepaired for a long time, but their graffiti just recently appeared. See, recently. This is a new story, Bodie. This isn't an old...
Just because it says recently...
Dude, it's Fox 40. Recent. Are you saying that you don't trust Fox 40?
I don't trust the news.
Okay. I don't even...
If the media doesn't come out of, like, 4chan or E-Bombs World or anything like that, it's not real.
Here's the thing is E-Bombs World actually did it.
That's true. That is actual fact. And 4chan served in the assist, and it was...
It's the Kekistanis.
It was the Kekistanis, and it was Shia LaBeouf's idea. So... They all work together.
What people don't understand is he's actually right. The heart of all of the Kekistanis.
So
he's a creator.
He's a freaking genius. Seriously,
I really think so.
He will not divide us.
He will not divide us.
Unless he does.
He will not divide us.
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 He can take the flag, and not take the man's idea.
He will not divide us.
You can take my freedom. But you can't take my flag! Yeah! Resident Jeff Peabody said he knows the guy who did it. Oh, it's just a guy. Never mind. And said
Resident
the guy,
Peabody?
Probably him.
Said the guy did it out of frustration. Watch the kid who lives around here. He got a ticket because his front license plate fell off going through there, so they gave him a ticket for not having a front license plate. This is not from England. I'm just
they're all just putting Drew Dick on the hoe just to fuck with him.
So basically So the residents are. I mean, here's a guy bringing attention to the fact that the government is pretty much, pardon the pun, boning them, and the
government's a bag of dicks, man.
And the resident guy is he's turning him in. He's literally turning him in here. I mean,
that's actually a really good idea, and I think I'm going to go to the Home Depot tomorrow morning, and I'm going to buy a rattle can to bring around in my car and put dicks on the road.
I was just going to say, probably not even just on potholes. Just
find a road with a dotted line.
And remember, children, we're just talking about pictures of giraffes here. With varying lengths and sizes. That's
no, we're talking about penises.
We're talking about your ass.
It's a giant veiny cock.
I don't know what you guys.
If you get naked, we could model it after you.
I don't. Oh gosh, I don't even know. How did I get on this show? I was walking down the street and somebody said, "Come in this booth and start talking." And here
you weren't even supposed to do a show.
I'm not supposed to do a show this week. I got coerced into it because I don't have my own free will and. I think Bodie knows that. So, do we go to another political story or do we go to another weird story?
Just do a story.
Just do
something.
A story. Whatever
just
is next
do a story.
In your feed.
All right. Next in my feed. The 28% of Trump's Twitter followers are eggs.
Eggs.
Eggs. 28%. Well, I don't know. You have to contact
them. So he's
them.
Bought 28%
of 28%
of
his Twitter followers are bots. That's what eggs means, Bodie. I know you're not sophisticated.
Why didn't he just go to the Trump tweet generator? That would have been a lot easier.
They didn't have a Trump tweet generator in the beginning. In the beginning, there was only spam. And then spam created real activity. And that's how it works, folks. Spam creates real activity. So... 28%
fake news becomes real news.
Perception is reality. So, yes, absolutely.
Everything that's fake is real, and everything that's real is fake.
And all the way around. Yeah, 20. That's
how the story goes. Yeah. And dicks fix the roads.
You just can't.
Dicks fix the roads.
Gotta stick dicks on that.
Fix,
gotta.
Dicks fix the roads.
I feel.
Dicks fix the roads.
Wow.
Dicks fix the roads.
Wow. I can't wait to share these videos with my mom.
I can see the campaign. I can see it happening.
Giant billboards.
Yeah. Giant billboards with like swastikas and commie sickles and just dicks. Dicks fix the road. That's something we can, the left and the right.
That's something you could have a protest and have people carrying on signs.
Yeah. Dicks fix the roads.
And giant banners.
Oh.
I'm gonna read the article and pretend.
And instead of like a bucket brigade, it could just be like a dick brigade or like a dildo brigade, and you're just
and they could have buckets of dicks.
Buckets of dicks. Oh, I just pour them in the hole.
Oh my gosh! Oh,
dump them into the potholes.
Wow! Now we're dumping them in potholes, really, really, James.
They could play games with it. You can make it a whole game, and you can see how far you can toss the dick into the pothole.
Wow.
And like you could have like a whole thing that you do with like spray paint little markers on the road and have like distance, and then you have a scoreboard right on the road.
You thought about it. You're not.
You're the first time he's thought of this.
No, I don't think this is the first time he's thought of this.
And you put a scoreboard on the road, and then you can mark how many feet it's been that you stood and you made the dick to go into the pothole.
Wow.
And that is how the roads get fixed, because the minute you start doing that,
we're
going to fix.
Where can we
have any potholes?
James, we're
going to be like, no potholes. These people are throwing dicks.
James, clearly you thought about this, so where are you selling the board game? Do you want to give it?
Game.
Oh, no, you're selling it because you thought about it. You have this written down. Where can we find the dick? Hey, that's a t-shirt right there, Bodie.
Thank you, Tammy.
Did Tammy come up with that? That's a t-shirt right there. I don't endorse any of this, by the way. I'm still sticking with this is giraffe. This is all about giraffe. Folks, this is all about giraffe. So 28%, I was going to get to this story. 28% of Donald Trump's Twitter followers are eggs. I love that title. I have to say, I'm going to give AmericaBlog.com a shout out. That's a great title. 28% of Twitter followers are eggs in Twitter parlance. An egg is trouble. Sometimes a bot, usually a troll. I don't know. Is it usually a troll when it's an egg? I don't do the Twitters much. So
if you troll, you'll go through the effort of making a profile picture.
You would think if you're going to troll, you're going to be a Kekistanian or a naked picture of James Weeks always works.
Or you'll just be Trump.
A close up of Bodie's nipple also works.
You're gonna need a really big close up to fill that screen.
I have
nipples.
I have those available.
Oh, Caleb has the perfect idea in the chat for how to deal with stop signs.
How do you deal with stop signs, Caleb?
You just look in the chat.
Oh, I got to look in the... No, if I look in the chat, I'm going to get an echoey. I had an issue, and it was like, even though I
you'll have to look afterwards.
I can't. We're not gonna include it in the show because James Weeks is being a.
I'll give you a hint.
Okay.
It is a dick.
Of course it is. It's ladies and gentlemen.
It's a horseshoe dick, basically.
Christine says Paul loves all of this. That is actual fake news. We have fake news in our thread right now. I want to get back to the Trump egg story. It's a safe place and it doesn't involve penises. I don't think so. Does it?
Fucking amazing.
Let's find out. Get back to the story, Paul.
Eggs were such bad news that Twitter recently changed its default avatar from an egg to, well, something that harkens to an adult toy. Wait, are you kidding me? Are you serious?
That'll get people to update their profile picture.
The heck?
No one wants to be going around like a penis unless they're actually a penis.
Don't be a. Bloomberg also found that of Trump's 10 most engaged Twitter followers over the past 30 days, five were rope. Wow, you had three sips and you're
No, I poured quite a bit in here. This hasn't been an energy drink for a while.
Oh, really? What did you have in there, Mr. Bodes?
I had the commie drinks.
Oh, wow. I'm drinking, listen, right here, folks, just drinking some tea. That's it. Tea.
Bullshit.
Tea. Look, it's tea. See, it's tea. Look, you can even see it's tea. It's tea. See that?
How defiant. Do you see it's tea?
That's
how do
you tea. See it's tea. You saw it was tea. You're it's clearly drinking. Tea. Well, I mean, here's the clue. You guys are drinking. I'm drinking tea. I have my clothes on. You guys don't. I think that's simple. That's what you call whiskey math. So eggs were such bad. Okay, so an adult toy. I don't know what the adult toy was, but somehow.
It might be an egg.
Might be an egg.
You know what? Hold on. I'm going to Google it.
It is good. This is very good.
New.
We were asked if this is good.
New Twitter default.
It's good. It's good for commies.
Profile.
If you're a hidden commie, it's the only drink you can drink.
Okay,
hidden
so I'm going
to make a hidden commie shirt, too.
I'm going to the
you
new
make a hidden commie shirt.
Okay, no, so
I have hidden commie, but with a U.
So listen, I want to be delicate here in pointing out that the new Twitter profile thingy, I would say that it's not a frontal issue, it's a back issue.
Oh, it's a butt.
No, it's something related to that area.
An anus?
It's definitely related to that area. But it's an implement. It's not the
Did you know humans have
now? James is going to clarify.
The anal sphincter is actually two sphincters.
I did not know that, and I
it's a double sphincter.
Wow, is that like a double rainbow? Do we walk pretty around much. With a metaphorical double rainbow with us wherever we go? Why aren't we happy all the time? We should be like...
Oh, it looks like a butt plug?
There you go. There you go. I knew you'd say it. See, I'm a decent human being.
I was thinking about it, and I'm thinking like an egg or something. And I'm like, oh.
Right. And well, there you go. So okay, it didn't deal with a front door. It dealt with a back door somehow. Somehow it was going to go in that direction because this is the theme of the show, folks. Now,
well, you could use it on any door.
I don't know. For a dude, that'd be kind of difficult.
Not for a dude. It doesn't have to be for a dude.
Well, no, it doesn't have. I'm just. Never mind.
Wow.
Well, you said door.
You just assumed a butt plug's gender.
I did.
Man, that's some cold shit.
I also assumed its race, so.
That is some cold shit.
Well, yeah. I mean, if you're going to be involved in a relationship with this type of device, the device is going to be very dramatic, over the top, because that's the way they are. Yeah. So, yeah. Now everyone...
Are you sure it's not a power bottom?
It could be.
Hey, that's what I named my shotgun before I lost it in a boating accident.
Wow.
Is there a shark, too, in yours?
Yeah.
Yeah. All I have.
Those fucking sharks, man. They get you every time.
Superior sharks. Superior
laser
sharks.
Beam, though.
Wow.
One of those blue lasers that catches fire faster.
Someone is angry reacting our video.
Yeah, why are you angry reacting to this video?
He's upset. He saw the slash poll and he's hoping that. He's hoping for some. You came to the wrong part, but he ranked wrong.
This is actually lefty pole. You didn't know, but this is hidden lefty pole.
Yeah, right. This is hidden lefty pole.
I'm not involved in any of the pole issues. I am pole neutral. So don't blame me. Don't blame me. I'm just a cameraman. You know, I'm just Uh-oh. Christine said, how dare you, Paul? How dare you, Christine? How dare you? I don't even know what.
We need some love reacts to counteract this
yes,
hate, people.
Yes, where's the love react?
Where's the love?
I feel dirty doing this.
Like,
but
I feel like the reason why we're getting angries is because Paul is not naked.
Yeah.
I can't believe that people you people really don't know. I like this. James Neese says this stream is called Paul. Where is the autism? Have you not been listening to this show, James? I mean,
he clearly hasn't.
Are you serious?
You're gonna have to go back in time.
We need to get way more autistic with it.
Yeah. So we're coming up to the end of the show because it's we got 6 minutes left.
Gentlemen, yeah, Hitler did nothing wrong.
Wow. Wow.
Now that's pretty autistic. Yeah, that's
okay.
I'm trying to reach the audience.
That's some Spicer shit.
Yeah, that is. And then this is Spicer's response.
His molecules never actually quite touched the button. It was just a resistance of forces.
That's right. Actually, yeah. Although Hitler did probably kill some people personally in World War One. So.
Himself.
No, he killed people in World War One, man. He did stuff.
He killed himself, too.
Well,
he was simultaneously.
You know what? Adolf Hitler is a hero.
Biggest hero.
He saved the world from Adolf Hitler. I mean, come on. I mean,
he's the biggest anti-hero.
That is some yin and yang stuff right there.
Adolf Hitler saved the world from Adolf Hitler.
Yeah, really? I mean, where's his parade?
He's both the world's biggest superhero.
You know who I admire the most? Adolf Hitler. What? Well, he killed Hitler. Oh. Oh, yeah.
You know what, though? Is that I really wish everyone who liked Adolf Hitler would follow their leader.
That'd be great. Leader. Follow the leader. He set the example. He set the example for everyone else.
He showed all the neo-Nazis what to do.
Get your Clorox.
Blueprint out. Take your stupid-ass pill. Shoot yourself in the head.
Yeah, I would just drink Clorox until it stops hurting.
Yeah, just drink bleach. All right, Nazis.
I think we're out of stories because I can't find anything else with a penis reference. So I'm trying. I'm trying. We got
Hitler didn't gas anyone.
We got 4 minutes left.
I think for this last 4 minutes, we should talk about why Nazis should drink bleach.
I don't know. Why should Nazis drink bleach?
They're Nazis.
It's a self-referential proof.
Yeah.
Oh, I love self-referential proof. Why should not? You know, because they're Nazis. Duh. What's wrong with Nazis? Well, they're Nazis. Duh. Duh.
By definition, the only good fascist is a dead one.
That's objective fact. But there's a lot more people that are fascists that don't realize it. So.
No, they don't know fascists.
They don't know that they are.
And they still vote. They still vote.
Well,
they need to start drinking way more bleach.
I
think that we need to institute something. We need to open up a Lulzilla restaurant. And then on the menu, we have just a checkbox.
Yeah.
And that's how you order.
Are you a Nazi or not? Yes.
You know, and that's
nothing
you
else. All we want to know is that. And if you're fascist, your meal is free.
If you're a Nazi, your meal's free.
Your meal is free. and you gotta take it. That's how we do it.
We need to open this restaurant. This restaurant would be the biggest hit.
It would be absolutely the biggest hit. It would probably.
I think the health department would give it like an A+.
I think that they would. Yeah, they would gloss right over it. They would just. No, they're good. They're good.
I mean, it's only Nazi. I mean, you can give Nazi
zero days since last success.
Right, they're doing COD's work over there. We're just gonna keep right on.
COD's work, the great COD in the sky.
The great COD in the sky is proud. Yes. So
I mean, why would they shut down a place that gives Nazis bleach?
I don't know.
Unless they're Nazis.
I don't know. Unless they're. I'm not going to give anybody bleach, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to make them buy it. So, you know, because I'm a capitalist. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. You're welcome.
All right.
You're welcome.
So, how about this?
All right.
Give them bleach. Steal the money
sponsored
in their
by
wallet.
Smurfs, by the way.
Yeah,
and then we'd be illegalists.
We'd be a mutualist after we, you know, we're like, hey, they weren't using it.
Oh!
You know what I'm saying, dude? I got all the bases covered here. Yeah,
you did it.
You're welcome.
You did it.
Thank you.
So that's the plan. We open up a mutualist Nazi killing restaurant.
I think that's the way to go. We got all our bases covered. We got all our bases covered, dude.
It's a business model. I don't see much viability. It won't last very long because there's really not that many Nazis. You know, they just make a lot of noise.
You're a real pessimist.
Open it up right next door to Richard Spencer's
house.
You're
a real pessimist there, buddy.
Or we can just close it up.
No. I'm okay with this business model failing. But by it failing, it will succeed.
Exactly. When
we run out of Nazis, that is success.
This business model is the perfect business model because when you fail, it means you success. You know, it was a success.
But what if you succeed? Then you're still succeeding because
you're working
towards the end. So it's
Pat
good.
Areola. Isn't that the name for the nipple? Areolas?
It's the area around the...
Yeah. Well, Pat around the area nipple asked, "Hey, James, what's the tattoo on your left arm?" Which is actually your right arm.
Not the Iron Cross, the other side.
Yeah.
Which arm are we talking about?
Not the cross, the other side, not the Iron Cross.
All they said was yup, as if we could
good,
know what
good, good one. Good to clarify.
The Anarchy A.
He's got the Anarchy A.
Oh, I thought that was for Al. Wasn't that your lover, Al? I thought that was for Al.
Yeah, that's for
Al. Right.
Al Franklin?
Yeah. Right. We have my family's coat of arms here. And then we have the Chaos Magic Star right there, which is kind of faint. My buddy did that shit. Like, I was hammered drunk one night after band practice. My buddy had just got a tattoo gun, and I was like, hey!
I fell all the way down.
Brilliant idea.
Yeah, it's like, that's actually how this show happened. So, that's exactly how. Hey, let's say that. Let's do this. So, you also have Claire de Lune on you, don't you? Claire de Lune.
Yeah, I mean that involves standing up, and I'm pretty drunk, and there's not much room in here.
We don't. I don't want you to stand up. I'm voting for James not to stand up. No, I don't want you to do that.
Trying to do ball.
No. We Napa is a property that we value, and we want to keep it. We want to keep it. Oh yeah, yes. We.
That sounds pretty.
Yeah, I just weed me in there. I just weed me right into Napalm.
That's yes in French. So you're not saying anything.
I'm wee wee. I'm weeing is what I'm doing. I'm weeing. Yes. I weed my way in.
Wee.
I weed my way in.
Wee.
Actually, I'm actually the face of Napalm. Truth be told, I'm the genius, the brains, the financing, all of it.
Everything but the financing, maybe.
Everything but the financing. I am the genius behind Napalm.
You are the genius.
I invented Bodhi, just so everybody knows. I did invent him. Yeah. I didn't mean to tell you that. You know what? Just when you play the show back, skip this part. When you get if you go on to this part and you hear this, it's already too late. You've been triggered. I apologize.
Yeah, that's fine.
You know
I've been
too much.
A lot today.
I guess it's time for Bodhi 4.0. I thought, because we had Bodhi 3.0 for a long, you lasted way longer than 2 and 1.
Yeah, it's just this time, can you make sure you don't implant the previous memories?
I can do that. I can absolutely, I will absolutely do that. I'm only, actually, the next iteration, you're only going to have memories of Tom and Jerry cartoons.
Oh, thank
That's
God.
That's it. So we're going to say goodbye here, at least on my end, for the recording part for YouTube's. And we have had...
We're going to cut the stream.
James, what's your what's your calling card? Where can they... Oh, my gosh. What are you, having a religious moment? What the heck was that? Or either that, or you're about ready to go into surgery. Or you're going into surgery. I must operate. Hold on. I have to go. Okay.
Find me on the Facebook.
And you're on Freedom Fiends, right?
Yeah, I'm on Freedom Fiends. Find me on the Freedom Fiends. FreedomFiends.com. Find me on the internet.
JamesWeeks.com,
JamesWeeks2nd.com.
If you Google
libertarian,
naked libertarian,
you'll find me. Yeah. If you Google libertarian stripper, you'll find me. If you Google James Weeks, you'll find me. Just find me.
Google liberty thongs.
If you Google penile implant, you'll find him. So there's that.
That's actually how you find Paul.
No. You can't step on that.
That's how you fight Paul.
And fresh cans of tuna.
Is scared to take his clothes off.
And we have
dicks and potholes. Is because he's afraid that one of those was a dick at one point.
When your roads are fixed, You can thank our dicks.
Okay.
Now that's a fucking sign.
And I have one here. I have Andrew Marriage, Bodhi Agora.
Why did you not cut the stream at that?
You fucked up right there.
That should have been the last thing that went out.
I'm trying to get everybody's call thingies. So Bodhi is at Napaw TV, and I am at, you just go to istate.tv, you'll find Paul Gordon. And hey, wait, repeat the thing that you said last that he said we were supposed to cut it off.
When your roads are fixed, you can thank our dicks.